Assalamu alaikum. Today we will talk about chapter 7, which is about techniques of integration. Up to now, we discussed section 5.4 and section 5.5. I mean, we had the fundamental theorem of calculus. We discussed specific types of functions. For example, integral ex, integral sine x, integral tan x, for example. We were able to find these. Now, what about the others? What about, for example, ln x? It is not given in the table. In fact, we will discuss it today in this section, which is section 7.1, integration by parts. Let me say very important note before we start this section. Basically, in calculus, we have two methods of integration. Method number one, U substitution. The second one, integration by parts. For the others in this chapter, I mean section 7.2, 3, etc., we will discuss specific types of functions. Here, he said every differentiation rule has a corresponding rule in integration. For instance, the chain rule corresponds to the substitution rule, and we said this in section 5.5. So this is the inverse process. Now, the product rule will correspond to the rule for integration by parts. That means integration by parts is the inverse process of the product rule in differentiation. Now let us see the formula for integration by parts. First, recall the product rule states that if f and g are differentiable functions, then we have the following. Why do we need f and g to be differentiable? This is very important because in the formula we have g prime and f prime. So for sure we need f and g to be differentiable. D by dx f g equal f g prime plus f prime g. You know this. You keep the first and you differentiate the second plus the other way around. Now, let us integrate both sides. If you integrate here, the integral will kill the derivative. So we are left with f of x, g of x. Integrate here to get f of x, g prime of x, and dx for sure. Plus integrate this, allow me to write g first. I mean g of x times f prime of x dx. Now let us rearrange. Let me put this in one side and this with this in the other side. So we will get the following. F of x, I mean here, g prime of x dx is equal what? This minus this integral. F of x, g of x minus this integral, which is g of x, f prime of x dx. All right. In fact, this formula is called the formula for integration by parts. Notice the following. We started with an integral and we end up with a new integral. Hopefully, this integral will be easier than the original one. It is similar idea to section 5.5. You remember, for example, we had x e to the power x squared. This is not given in the table, but if we use the substitution u equal x squared, for example, then this integral will be half e to the power u. And clearly, this integral is easy. This is for the substitution. We will have similar idea in integration by parts. This is the formula, as I said, we need to memorize it. Or it is better to remember this formula using the following notation. The notation will be as follows. Let u equal f of x and let v equal g of x. Now let us differentiate. Du will be f prime of x dx and dv will be g prime of x dx. Let us put this here. See here, our f is u. So this is my f and I can see f here. So this is my u. V is g. So I will write v here and v here. What is f prime dx? We said it is du. So everything here will be du. We are left with g prime of x dx. Read it from here. It is dv. The formula is given as follows. U dv equal uv minus v du. In fact, we will know this formula using some boxes. We will see it in the following examples. Question number one. Find the integral of x sine x dx. Well, this is a famous example in integration by parts. If you have polynomial times sine, polynomial times cosine, polynomial times exponential function, then this is a famous question in integration by parts. Here we have a general side note. It is helpful to use the following boxes or this pattern. you write U in this box, you write DV in this box, DU here, V here. If we do it this way, look at this formula. It is UV, that means U multiply this way, then you have minus VDU. See here, this is V, this is DU. That means U integrate with a minus this way. So this is the pattern that we need to know. All right, clearly we need to take something to be U and something to be DV. Well, this comes from experience. First, let us choose U to be X, the polynomial. And let us choose DV, the rest, which is sine X and with the DX. For the other way around, I will do it after this example. Wait, now let us fill the boxes. DU equal 1 DX. And hence from here, if we have DV, I need to integrate to get V. And what is that? That is minus cosine x. Then my integral will be, as we said, you need to multiply this way, minus integrate this way. Hence, I will get x times minus cosine, minus integral, multiply them, you will get minus cosine x dx. Now, wait. As I said, this is the original integral, will give us a new integral here on the right hand side. Ask yourself, is this integral easy? The answer is yes. We discussed this in the table of section 5.4. So proceed. I will say minus x cosine x plus, I mean minus with a minus, integral of cosine. This will be sine x plus constant c. And this is the answer. Note number one, it is good for you to differentiate and check your solution. I mean, if you differentiate this, you should get x sine x. Let us see this. D by dx of minus x cosine x plus sine x plus constant c equal to what? Using the product rule over here, differentiate minus x, we get minus 1. Keep the cosine plus the other way around. Write minus x and differentiate cosine, that is minus sine x. Now let us go for the sine, differentiate it for sure, you will get cosine x. Differentiate c, you will get 0. Now let us simplify. Minus cosine will go with cosine, minus with the minus, it will be plus x sine x. This is what we had inside the integral. That means our work is correct. Now let us see this note. What about if we choose the other way around? Let us read this note. Our aim in using integration by parts is to obtain a simpler integral than the one we started with. If we had chosen the other way around, u equal to sine and dv to be x, dx. Here I need to find du, that means you differentiate, you get cosine x dx. Now integrate, you will get x squared over 2. Now our integral x sine x dx will be, multiply this way, you will get x squared over 2 sine x minus, multiply this way with an integration, you will get x squared over 2 cosine x dx. Now ask yourself, is this new integral simpler than the original one? The answer is no. See it this way. The power for the polynomial here is 1. After we do integration by part, we get the power to be 2. That means we are increasing the power. And this means that we are making things worse and worse. So we are getting new hard integral, which is much more difficult than the original one. So if you see the situation, what shall you do? You need to switch. I mean, you need to take u to be your x and sine x, leave it with the dv. Now we have some advice. In general, we try to choose u equal f of x to be a function that becomes simpler when differentiated, or at least not more complicated, as long as dv, which is g prime of x dx, can be easily integrated to give v. Once we write u and dv, from here to here, I need to integrate. So I need dv, read here, to be easily integrated to give v. And for u, I need it to become simpler when we differentiate. To apply this general rule, we have something called Layat rule. This rule is not given in the textbook. Usually it is helpful, but sometimes it fails. So let us be careful here. Layat rule says that choose u to be the function that comes first in this list. L-I-A-T-E. L stands for the logarithmic function. For example, log 2x or ln x. For I, this is inverse trig function, for example, sine inverse and tan inverse of x. For a, algebraic function, for example, x, x square, root x. T stands for trig function, for example, sine and cosine.
E stands for the exponential function, for example, ex and 2 to the power x. In fact, I did this rule for the previous example. We have algebra and we have trig. Which one comes first in the list? For sure, algebra comes before the trig function. So it is recommended to take u equal x and dv to be sine x. As I said, this advice, sometimes this Layat rule will fail. And if it fails, what shall I do? I gave you a solution here. If Layat rule fails, try different choices for u and dv. We have little note, it is sometimes helpful to make a substitution before integration by parts. And this is usually helpful if you have composite of functions. We will do this in later examples. Question 1a, find the integral of ln x dx. As I said at the beginning of this section, this is a famous exercise in integration by part. If we apply Layat, only we have one single function, so take it to be your u. So u will be ln x and dv in this case will be dx. Du will be 1 over x dx, v clearly x. Now let us write this arrow from here to here. Then you need to integrate horizontally like this. Integral of ln x dx is equal ln x times x minus, don't forget to multiply these guys, x times 1 over x dx. Now you have a new integral. This integral, is it easy? The answer is yes. You can simplify to get 1 dx. Here we have quick note, x cannot be 0 clearly because it is clear from the domain of ln x. X should be greater than 0. Now, what is this integral? Clearly it is minus x plus constant c. Now just copy these, x ln x and x ln x. So the final answer is x ln x minus x plus constant c. Now it's good for you to check the derivative. If we differentiate this, using the product rule, I will say x times derivative of ln x, this will be 1 over x. We are not done yet, plus ln x times the derivative of x, which is 1, so I will not write it, minus differentiate x, it should be 1. If you simplify x over x, this is 1, and it will go with 1, so we are left with ln x. That means our formula is correct. Now I will give you a question to try. Integral x to the power 5 ln x dx. Take 2 minutes. All right, time is up. Let us start solving this question together. If we apply Layat, clearly L comes first. That means the logarithmic function. So we will take it to be our u. U equal ln x. And clearly dv will be x to the power 5. Always and always, do not forget to write dx always with the dv. Here, I need to find du, which is clearly 1 over x dx. Now I need v, that is x to the power 6 over 6. So our integral I, which is this one, is equal this by this, x to the power 6 over 6 ln x, minus, multiply these guys horizontally with an integral to get the following. This will be minus x to the power 5 over 6 dx. And as we said, this is an easy integral. Let us do it and finish the solution. This will be x to the power 6 over 6. By this 6, you will get 36 plus constant c. Copy this. So the final answer for this exercise is given here. Here we have a note before we solve part C. It says sometimes we have to use integration by parts more than once. You remember the L'Hopital rule? Sometimes we need to use it more than once. I mean one time, two times, three times, etc. Here we have the same situation. We will end up with a new integral. That new integral needs to be done by part again. An example of this is integral of t squared e to the power t dt. And as I said, this is again a famous example in integration by part, polynomials times exponential function. Here, we will take u to be t squared. Maybe you can apply Layat. L, we do not have L. Do we have inverse? No. Do we have A? Yes, which is algebraic. We have it here. And dv will be e to the power t dt. Now, if we differentiate, we get 2t dt. Here, let us find v by integration, which is e to the power t. So our integral I is equal t square e to the power t. We are multiplying this way, minus integrate this way horizontally, minus integral 2t e to the power t dt. All right, now this new integral need to be done using integration by part again. How can we see this? Look at the power. We started by t square. After we do one integration by part, we get the power to be t. Next, we expect that if we do one more integration by part, this t will be t to the power 0. Then we are done with integration by part. All right. Now, I prefer to put this minus inside because we will have lots of minuses. by integration by parts again, use the same letters u equal minus 2t and dv equal e to the power t dt. Why? Because once we are done with integration by part, we give you this integral. No need to use new letters. So I will write du here, which is minus 2 dt. And I will write v, which is simply e to the power t. Again, this integral alone will be, see the arrows, you multiply this with this to get minus 2t e to the power t. Do not forget, minus integrate horizontally. Multiply this with this to get minus 2 e to the power t dt. This is the end of the solution. Just copy paste this down here. This will be t square e to the power t. This is minus 2 t e t. Now minus with the minus will be plus. And we have 2 integration of e t. This is symbol e to the power t plus constant c. All right. As I said, you see here, we started with t square. Then after one integration by part, we get t here. Another time of integration by part, we get t to the power 0. Now it's good for you to differentiate this to check whether our work is correct or not. We have a question in the chat. He said, why do you remove that minus? See here, we have this minus, and when we multiply, we get this minus with this minus. Sometimes you will have more minuses. I mean, one minus outside. One minus comes from the integration. And if we have definite integral, then you need to evaluate from A to B, then you have another minus. Sometimes you will miss those minuses. It's up to you. If you leave it here, then you need to multiply whatever you have here with a minus. Part D. He said, find the integral of ex sine x dx. Again, this is another famous example of integration by part, which has a nice idea. I mean cycling. Here you need to do the integration twice. The idea is here. If you differentiate sine, you will get cosine. If you differentiate this cosine, you will end up with minus sine. That means we will get back to the original integral. Here, let us take u to be sine x and dv equal e to the power x dx. Here I am following layout. However, you can choose the other way around. I mean, you can choose u equal ex and you can choose dv to be sine x dx. In fact, this is done in example number 4 in our textbook. Please see it. Now, du will be cosine x dx and v will be ex. So our integral I, which is this one, can be written as sine x times exponential function. I am multiplying this way. Minus integrate horizontally to get minus ex cosine x dx. All right, we end up with a new integral similar to this one. But instead of sine, we have cosine. So again, you need to do integration by part. And for sure, we will get ex sine x. And we will deal with it. As I said, for me, I will put this minus inside. You need to take u, as you did here, to be the trig function. Dv to be minus ex dx. Du here will be minus sine x dx. And v will be minus integration of ex, this e to the power x. We do the arrows like this. Now, do you see this integral? I will write it here. It will be this by this. That is minus cosine x times e to the power x minus integral of what? Look here. You multiply this with this. Minus with the minus will be gone. And you are left with sine x ex dx. So ex sine x dx. Now let us copy paste this, and this is equal to I. Now wait, what is integral ex sine x? It is our original integral. So you have minus I on this side, move it to the next side to get to I equal whatever you have here. Then you divide by 2, and this is our solution. Equal ex sine x minus ex cosine x. Now divide by 2, I will be 1 over 2. E to the power x sine x minus ax cosine x. And do not forget to add the constant c. And it's good for you to check your answer by differentiating it. As I said, this is a famous example, which is part D. Another version of it is to change sine with cosine. Already we did it here inside the question, but I will give you some time to try it from the scratch. And in general, we can change x to be a polynomial of degree 1. I mean, we can change x to be minus x, and we can change this x to be 2x or 3x or 4x. It is the same procedure, but you will not get minus I only. You may get minus third I. Just simply put it in the other side and complete your work. So let us take 2 minutes to solve part E or F. Now we see part G. It says integrate sine inverse of x dx. If you have single function like this, then you can try integration by part as follows. Take u equal sine inverse of x, dv will be dx. What is my du in this case? Yes, you are right, 1 over 1 minus x square under the root dx, and here v will be my x. If we do our arrows like this, then our integral sine inverse of x will be this by this, will give you x sine inverse of x minus integrate horizontally x over root 1 minus x square dx. Now I will stop and I will ask you this question. Can you integrate this function? The answer should be using substitution rule. Be careful. Some students say it is sine inverse. It's not correct. If you have 1 over this, like this, then this is sine inverse. If you have x upstairs, no, this is a question using the substitution rule. Here I will say let w equal what? 1 minus x squared, because the derivative is upstairs. And see, I use the letter w because u and v are reserved for integration by part. If you take w to be this, then dw will be minus 2x dx. And hence, my integral over here will be x dx, read it from here, it is dw over minus 2. Or in other words, that is minus half dw over root w. And this can be written as minus half w to the power minus half. Am I right? W to the power minus half, just add 1 into the exponent to get 1 over 2. And multiply by the reciprocal, which is 2, and add that constant c if you wish. Simplify here, you will get minus root 1 minus x squared plus constant c. So the final answer will be, we have minus here and minus here. Let me write it. And let us copy x sine inverse of x. X sine inverse of x plus the root. All right, and I advise you to check your solution. I mean, differentiate this, you will get sine inverse. Also, similar example is tan inverse or cosine inverse. These are famous examples in integration by part. You should try them yourself. Integral of tan inverse of x. This is the solution. Take 2 minutes. All right, time is up. Here we need to integrate tan inverse, which is a single function. Let u equal tan inverse of x. Dv will be dx. In this case, du will be 1 over 1 plus x squared dx. V will be x. If you multiply this way minus integrate this way, the integral of tan inverse will be as follows. X tan inverse of x, I am multiplying this way, minus integrate horizontally. I mean x times this to get 1 plus x squared. Again, how to integrate this? Usually the students miss it. If you have 1 over 1 plus x squared, then this is tan inverse. But if you have x over 1 plus x squared, this would be ln. I will write the details here. Let w equal 1 plus x squared. Dw equal 2x dx. And in this case, x over 1 plus x squared will be written as follows. This is half dw. See here, x dx, read it from here. Divide by 2 for both sides only. Over, everything is called w, half ln absolute value of w plus constant c. Tell me my w. That is 1 plus x squared. All right. And here, no need to put the absolute value because the quantity here is positive. I will just copy it, paste it. This is given here. That is half ln 1 plus x squared. And do not forget to copy this. So this is the answer. I advise you to differentiate this to check your solution. Note, how to evaluate definite integrals by integration by parts? Well, you need to evaluate both sides of formula number one. This is formula number one, by the way. Between A and B, assuming F prime and G prime are continuous, and use the fundamental theorem to get the following. We said integral fg prime dx equal fg minus integral gf prime dx. Simply, to integrate from a to b, you need to put the integral from a to b, and for this term, you need to evaluate directly from a to b. All right? One will ask this question, why do we need this condition, f prime and g prime, to be continuous? Look here, we have g prime and we have f prime. And you remember, we need whatever inside the integral to be a continuous function. To understand this, let us see the following example. Question 3. Find the integral from 1 to e to x ln x dx. We need to apply Layat. It is helpful. So clearly, we need to take u to be L, which is the logarithmic function. So I will say u equal ln x and dv equal 2x dx. I will get 1 over x dx. Here, I need to integrate. So clearly, this integral will be x squared. Now, our integral from 1 to e to x ln x is equal what? You multiply this way, minus integrate presently. So the answer will be x squared ln x minus, multiply this by this with an integral, we will get integral of x, right? X squared divided by x is x, dx. Now, see the changes. Here, I will evaluate directly from 1 to e, and here I will integrate from 1 to e. Note, this is a number. Just work it out. If you apply e here, you will get e squared ln e, and that is e squared. Remember, ln e is 1. Minus, if you plug 1, ln L1 is 0. So we are done with this term. Now let us finish this. What is the integral of x? Clearly it is minus x squared over 2, evaluated from 1 to e. So let us work this out. Minus, this will be e squared over 2 minus, plug 1, you will get 1 over 2. And remember, already we finished with this. So we get e squared. Now if you simplify this, e squared minus e squared over 2, this is e squared over 2. Minus half, this will be plus half. And this is the answer for this exercise. Also, there is a natural way. Maybe someone will say, I will forget about the endpoints here. I will evaluate the indefinite integral first. Then at the end of the day, I will plug 1 and e. Is this correct? Yes, it is correct. Let us do it quickly here. So our integral 2x ln x without limits will be this by this, x squared ln x minus, multiply this by this. For sure, you will get x dx. Now, finish everything. X squared ln x minus x squared over 2 plus constant c. Now, if you substitute from 1 to e and you put here from 1 to e, this will be e squared minus e squared over 2, all right, minus plug 1, this will be 0 minus 1 over 2, all right. And if you simplify, you will get the same solution. I mean e squared over 2 plus 1 over 2. Question 4. He said, prove the reduction formula. Integral of sine x to the power n dx equal whatever we have here. Look here, why do we call it a reduction? We started with sine to the power n, and we end up with a new integral sine to the power n minus 2. So the power is decreased by 2. Let us prove it, then we will apply it in some examples. We will prove this using integration by part. So if we call this integral to be I, then I will be integral sine n minus 1 x times sine x. I am saving one sine. What is the reason for this? Because I will take u and dv accordingly. So my u will be sine x to the power n minus 1. And I will choose dv to be sine x. Why? Remember, we said we need dv to be easily integrated, right? What is the derivative of this? Think about this as follows. Sine x all to the power n minus 1. So the derivative will be n minus 1, sine n minus 2. I am decreasing the power by 1. Am I done? No. You need to differentiate the inside function, which is sine x. So you need to multiply by cosine x dx. Now, what is the antiderivative here? It is minus cosine x. Now, our I becomes multiply this by this, minus integrate horizontally like this. So this will be minus cosine x sine to the power n minus 1 x minus integrate horizontally. See here, you have a minus here and you have a minus here. So if you multiply them, you will get plus. Write this, n minus 1 and this sine. All right, now we are left with cosine here and cosine here. If you multiply them, you will get cosine square x dx. This step number 1 is to save one sign. Now, step number 2 is to use this identity. Cosine square x equal 1 minus sine square. And expand. Let me explain this. You see this cosine square? Write it as 1 minus sine square. So let me copy this first. All right. Now expand inside the integral. Look here, you have n minus 1 times this sine, multiply it by 1 first. then multiply this by this by the sine square. All right, we have a question. He said, where is the cosine come from in the du? Look here, if you have, for example, sine x all cubed, this is like y. What is your y prime? Clearly, you will say 3 whatever inside square. I need to write sine x. Now, do not forget to differentiate the inside function. Clearly, that is cosine x. All right, where did we stop? Yes, as I said, multiply n minus 1 times this sine times 1. We get n minus 1 sine n minus 2 x times this number 1. And do not forget the x. We are not done yet. Now, multiply this n minus 1 with this sine n minus 2 with this sine square. We get minus integral n minus 1. Now, add the power to be n, right? Because n minus 2 plus 2 will be n. So, this will be sine to the power n x dx. Now, ask yourself, what is the integral of sine to the power n x dx? Look here. It is your I. So, this is your I. Now, let us move this n minus 1 times I on the left-hand side to get n minus 1 times I. Look here, it is a minus, it became plus here. Plus this I equal whatever you have here. So allow me to copy it. Now what is this? This is n I minus I plus I. They will cancel each other. So I will say n I equal whatever you have here. So I will copy it. Now to get I, what shall you do? You just divide by n. So if I divide by n, this will be minus 1 over n, right? Divide by n here, and if you divide by n, this will be cancelled. So let us double check the formula. Minus 1 over n cosine x sine n minus 1, see it here. N minus 1 over n, see it here. Integral sine n to the power minus 2, see it here. For sure, we have a condition here. N should be greater than or equal to, and it is an integer. All right? Now, let us see an application for this reduction formula. And he said, use the reduction formula to find the integral of sine to the power 5x dx. Just use the reduction formula with n equal to 5. So if we put 5, we get sine to the power 5x dx is equal minus 1 over 5 cosine x. Put 5 here, you get sine to the power 4x plus, put 5 here and here, you will get 4 over 5 integral. If you put 5 here, you will get 3 in the power. So you get sine cubed x dx. So be careful. The reduction formula does not give you the answer directly. It gives you a new integral. Look here. We decrease the power by 2. Now, what about integration of sine cubed? Again, use reduction formula again. As I said, use reduction formula with n equal to 3 to get the following. Put 3 here to get sine cubed x dx equal minus 1 over 3 cosine x sine square x plus, put 3 here, you will get 2 over 3 integral of sine x dx. Now we get integral of sine of x, and this is very easy. That is minus cosine x. So this is the answer. It is this term plus 4 over 5 integral of sine cubed. What is integral of sine cubed? We evaluate below. All right, and do not forget to add a constancy. Now, let me give you another exercise. We will solve it mentally only. Assume we ask you to evaluate the integral of sine to the power 7. We will need the previous one. I mean, subtract 2. We need to integrate sine to the power 5. How to integrate sine to the power 5? We need the previous one. That is integral of sine cubed. How to integrate this? We need integral of sine x. So it is better for you to start from the smallest. I mean, you evaluate integral of sine, this is easy. You find integral of sine cubed, then you evaluate sine to the power 5, and hence you put n equal to 7 and use the previous ones. Do you see the beauty of reduction formula? Let us read this remark. Remark: the reduction formula is helpful because by using it repeatedly, we could eventually express integral sine to the power n x dx in terms of the following. If the power n is odd, as I said, we will end up with integral of sine x, and that is easy. And what about if the power n is even? Look here. If I say integrate sine to the power 6, for sure I need the previous one, which is sine to the power 4. And the previous one is sine square. And what is the previous one? It is integral sine x all to the power 0. You can see it over here, which is integral of 1 dx. Here I have a quick note. You remember this exercise, integral sine to the power 5? We will solve it in section 7.2 using an easy method. Look here, we have more formulas. He said here use integration by parts to prove the reduction formula. Here, integral of ln x, integral x in ex, and integral of tan x, integral of secant in x. All of these can be done using integration by parts. So do not memorize them. What we need from you is to prove them and apply them. Tabular integration. Tabular integration is a special technique for integration by parts that can be applied to certain functions. Look here, it is an integration by parts. It's not a new method. And we will consider only this case. Polynomial times one of the following. Sine or cosine ax plus b. Look here. This is a polynomial of degree 1. Or a polynomial times exponential function like this. Look here. A to the power cx plus d. If you need an example, look here. 2 to the power 4x plus 2. Or sinh ax plus b or cosh ax plus b. By the way, this is the hyperbolic cosine and this is the hyperbolic sine. If you have one of these cases, you can apply the tabular integration. We have 5 parts here. This is integral of polynomial times exponential, so we will apply tabular. Again, this is similar. Also here we have polynomial times hyperbolic cosine, we will apply tabular. Here we have polynomial times cosine, so we will apply tabular integration. By the way, this question is already solved in question number 2, I guess. Now let us apply tabular. Sometimes it is called DI method. That means you have derivative here and you have integration here. Put U here and put DV here. What is my u here? It should be the polynomial because it will degenerate after some derivatives. This is my u, which is x square. Dv is ex. All right. Now let us differentiate. We get 2x. Differentiate. You will get 2. Differentiate. You will get 0. So stop. Now integrate. Ex, you will get ex. Integrate ex again. It is ex. Integrate, you will get ex. Now put arrows like this. This with this. And this with this, and this with this. You have plus, you have minus, and you have plus. I will explain the reason for having plus and minus. Now, what is the answer? It is written in front of you. X squared times EX with a plus sign. Now, add this by this with a minus sign. Next, this with this with a plus sign. So, I will write the answer directly here. It is X squared EX, and as I said, minus this with this, 2X EX. And what else? We have plus 2ax. And do not forget to add a constant c. So this is the final answer. All right, now let us understand what is the reason for having plus and minus. Let us recall this exercise already done in part c. Look here. As we said, our u is x square and dv equal ax. So we are at the first row. Then we differentiate, we get 2t and we get et. Look here, 2x and ex. Now, what we did is the following. We multiply this by this. Look at it here. This by this with a plus sign for sure. Then we integrate with a minus sign. Right? So this is the reason for having this minus. Look here. Again, we had integration by part. 2x and ex. And we differentiate, we get 2. You can see it here. We integrate, we get ex. And we have it here. Now we integrate again with a minus sign. You see it over here? So we have minus. With this minus, it becomes plus. All right. So we solve the question fully here. And we solve it in a table here. And this is the reason for calling it a tabular integration. Part B, he said, integrate x squared cosine 3x. You remember that? We will take our d to be x squared. And we will take our I, which is a notation for integration, to be cosine 3x. Now differentiate here. You will get 2x. Differentiate, you will get 2. Differentiate, you will get 0. Now integrate cosine 3x. It will be sine 3x, but we need to divide by 3. From where I get this 3, to use a substitution. Call it w, for example. W equal 3x. Then this will be cosine w. I am not done. My dw is 3dx. dw over 3 will be dx. So I will say dw over 3. Do you see from where we get this 3? All right. Now let us do it again. Integral of sine 3x is minus cosine 3x. And we need to divide by another 3. You have 3 and this new 3, it will be 9 in the denominator. Now let us integrate more. Cosine 3x it will be sine 3x and divide by a new 3, it will be 27 in the denominator, and do not forget this minus. Now put an arrow from here to here, put plus minus plus minus plus minus etc. So what is the final answer? It will be x squared times this, that is 1 over 3 x squared sine 3x minus, with this minus it will be plus 2x over 9 times cosine 3x. Just read from the table. We are left with 2 times this, it will be minus 2 over 27, and do not forget this sine 3x, and we have a plus constancy. So this is the final answer for this exercise. Now I will give you 1 minute or two to try one of the following, part C or D or E. All right, time is up. Let me solve part D quickly. We put x here and we put hyperbolic cosine here. Differentiate, you will get 1. Differentiate, you will get 0. That's it. Integrate here. Integral of cosh is sinh, right? Integrate sinh, you will get cosh. No minus. All right. Multiply this way, you have a plus, you have a minus. So what is the final answer? Clearly, this is x sinh x minus cosh x. Now, if we need to evaluate from 0 to 1, simply you evaluate everything here from 0 to 1. If you apply 1, you will get 1 times sinh 1, that is sinh 1, minus cosh 1. If you apply 0, you will get 0 times sinh 0, that is 0, minus cosh 0, you will get 1. If you use the definition of sinh and cosh, believe me, you will get this answer, which is 1 minus 1 over e.
This is the end of section 7.1.